Tension as hoodlums invade Fulani camp, killed two herders in Ebonyi. Residents of Okwachi Ishieke community in Ebonyi, local government area of Ebonyi State, have fled their homes over fear of reprisal attack following gruesome murder of two young herders by yet to be identified hoodlums at Okwachi Forest. Orient Weekend gathered that the attackers invaded a Fulani camp in the area at night and launched a surprised attack that culminated in the death of two persons, Adamu Ibrahim, 7 years, and Jibril Ibrahim, 15 years. The bloody attack, which took place around 9 p.m. on September 28, also left others injured and received treatment at AE Federal Teaching Hospital, Abakiliki. The Public Relations Officer of the Ebonyi State Police Command, DSP Lovett Odder, who confirmed the incident in a statement, disclosed that the Commissioner of Police and the State, CP Philip Sulemaku, has ordered full investigation into the mayhem. According to order, one Ado Ibrahim, a Fulani herdsman, who reported at Ishieke Division that the victims are his grandchildren and that the attack took place at their camp in the aforementioned area while the children were sleeping after cow grazing on the 28th September 2020 by 9 p.m. Meanwhile, the Commissioner of Police, who undertook a tour to the area, has ordered full-scale investigation into the matter with a view to arrest the perpetrators who fled the scene immediately after the incident. He also urges the general public, especially herders, to remain calm and not to embark on any reprisal attack, as the command under his watch will leave no stone unturned for the interest of justice. Thank you for listening to this news. You see what we are saying, my viewers? You see the immediate action they are taking. You see the immediate move the Nigerian police and the commissioner are taking. The state governors, you can see their immediate move, because it is now an issue of the death of an elder. Everyone wants to take an action. Everyone wants to make sure that the right thing is done. You see? This is what we are saying. If it is the issue of, okay, an Igbo man that is killed, I tell you, you will not hear anything. 24 hours will come and go, and nobody will do anything about it. But now, it is not the issue of an herder. You see that now? You see that? Oh, my viewers, it is good that they are the one that kill themselves. They are the one that kill themselves. So let them continue killing themselves. Is it not the bandits that attacked them? Are they not the same bandits? It is the same herdsmen that are still the same bandits. So they just disguise themselves. So let them face it, because it is their problem. It is a problem. I'm not in any way sympathizing with them, because The atrocities that these people have committed in the southeast is enough for people to think about. It's enough for people to get worried of. I'm telling you, the painful part of it, why is to be a little bit painful, is because the people killed here, the Fulanis that are killed are still infants. You understand? That is where it can be a little bit painful. But if you decide to say that, okay, let me face reality, you see that these people doesn't deserve any mercy. You see that they don't deserve any mercy because they have, in fact, they have killed too many people. Too much. And it is totally, in fact, it's so painful. Completely painful. So if you say you have sympathy on them, you may not even want to. You may not even want to. Because of what these people have done. You understand? Because of what they have done. You get it? So, my viewers, I tell you that though it's so worrisome and so painful concerning the attack, but they are the ones that attack themselves. They attack themselves. They attack their own brothers. You get it? So that is why one doesn't even need to get himself worried about it. And again, I'll tell you that our federal government and state governments are not being fair and sincere. When things of this kind happens, be it to a northerner or an easterner, let there be equal treatment. Let there be equal treatment. This is what I've been saying. Our southeast governors have been biased. I don't know if it is because the person in power is a northerner or a Fulani man, so they are trying to please him. They are trying to please him, which is completely wrong. But if it is their own brothers, they will just remain mute and won't say anything. Is it right? Or the man like that. Oh, my viewers, enough is enough. We cannot continue like this. Right? We can't continue like this. Something really needs to be done. Like, seriously. So please, you do well to leave your comment below the comment box. Click on the subscription button as well as the bell button to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.